Many modern ships have a bulbous bow. However, there is a mystery if Clive Palmer's replica Titanic, called Titanic II, will have one or not. The concept of a bulbous bow did not exist in 1912 when the original RMS Titanic was built. So what is it? It is a protruding bulb at the front of a ship just below the waterline. Water tank tests and computer simulation, not available in 1912, tell us that a bulbous bow modifies the way the water flows around the hull, reducing drag. This reduces fuel consumption and can increase the speed and the range of the vessel. Large ships with a bulbous bow generally have up to 15% better fuel efficiency than similar vessels without one. It also increases the buoyancy of the forward part of the ship and hence reduces the pitching of the ship to a small degree. All the renderings of the Titanic II's hull currently available were issued in 2013. A model of the ship was tested in a water tank in Germany, also in 2013. Neither renderings of the ship or images of the tank test show a bulbous bow. In recent years, cruise ships are being built with new style vertical bows. For example, NCL's Project Leonardo ships named after Leonardo da Vinci. There are also other new ships with inverted or X bows. Neither designs require a bulbous bow. However, for aesthetic reasons, the Titanic II cannot have either of these designs, irrespective of their efficiency. This rendering is not Titanic II. It is a replica Titanic concept known as the South African Titanic of 1998. It never came to fruition. However, you can see that this concept does have a small bulbous bow. The design of Titanic II's hull has almost certainly progressed over the past decade. The hull design may have been modified by naval architects Delta Marin. Titanic II may well have a bulbous bow now. We just don't know as yet.